I had to pinch a wire between the lid and the body of a grill the other day. And I didn't like it. I didn't like it at all. I got to do something about it. All right, so recently I did a video about putting a slot in the Weber kettle so that I could feed a sensor probe wire through without having to pinch it between the lid and the kettle body. And that works fine. I also recently did a Thanksgiving video about doing rotisserie turkey and some other things on the grills. And while I was doing the rotisserie turkey, in order to get the sensor probe in the rotisserie attachment, I needed to run it under the lid, pinching it between the rotisserie ring and the lid. I don't like that. Now, I don't really want to cut another slot in the rotisserie ring because there's a different way to do it. I'm going to add another sensor port. It's going to be the same type of sensor port that I added to the Oklahoma Joe's Highland, but this one's going to go in the rotisserie ring. And I thought I'd show you how I'm going to do it. So here is my Weber kettle with the rotisserie ring attached. And this is what I'm going to be putting the sensor port in today. So let me give you a closer look. This is the sensor port that I'm going to be installing today. It is a silicone grommet that I believe is made for the Weber Smoky Mountain. I've also installed it on my Oklahoma Joe's Highland offset. Now the reason I'm going to be installing this is pretty simple. So let me show you on the kettle and rotisserie setup. So this is the Weber 22-inch kettle with the rotisserie ring added to it. As I showed in a previous video, the ring is actually secured to this using two screw holes, one over here and one over here, with some self-tapping screws that go through the kettle and into the ring. That way there's no chance of it tipping. One of the things that's going to do today is make it easier to actually install this on here, because I'm not even going to have to take it off and mount it anywhere. I'm going to be able to drill with it right here on the kettle. When I was doing a video recently with a turkey on the rotisserie, I actually brought the sensor wire in here and had the probe mounted down here. Now, there were no coals in the middle of this. There were coals on either side and a drip pan in the middle. Okay, so some of you may be thinking, why not just put the sensor port down here, right in the kettle wall? Well, the problem with that is that sensor port's always going to be there. It's not going to come in and out. If I have charcoal right in here, near where the sensor port would be installed, that would be 800 degrees plus temperature potentially at times. That silicone grommet, I do not believe, is made to deal with that sort of temperatures. By mounting it further up here on the removable rotisserie ring in a position that's in line with the rotisserie rod, it's not going to be directly over coals that are that hot. So now my choice is to mount it where you're looking right now, which is where the motor end of the rotisserie is, or on the opposite side where the handle of the spit protrudes. I'm going to mount it right about here. Now, why wouldn't I mount it directly under where the handle goes through? This is a welded seam right here, and I really don't want to drill into that. I know it's probably strong enough. I don't want to take any more material out, so it's just going to be over this way about an inch or so. Now, if you've installed one of these sensor ports on something like an Oklahoma Joe's with thicker metal, you know that that drill bit going through is a little bit of a chore. This metal's a lot thinner. It's not going to be quite as hard as that. But basically what we're going to need is a drill, metal drill bits, a step drill bit that's going to get us up to an inch and a quarter diameter hole, some drilling fluid to help lubricate it a little bit. It's not going to be as important on this thin metal as it was on the thicker metal of the Oklahoma Joe's. We're also going to need a ruler to just sort of dial in exactly where we're going to make our hole, and safety glasses, because you will have metal shavings flying potentially. So let's get started by marking the location. So here is the slot where the handle end of the spit comes out. I want to go just over here a little bit. I want to come down about an inch and over about an inch and a half. And I'm just gonna make a little mark. That's where the pilot hole's gonna go. Now I'm gonna start with a very small drill bit just to get a pilot hole going. Now that we have our pilot hole drilled, we're gonna step up and go to a slightly larger drill bit. And we'll step it up again. Okay, we are ready now to actually move up to the step drill bit, which is one of these. If you've never used one of these, you have to be careful because each one of these is a different diameter. You'll see the numbers on here. We are going to the second to last diameter right here. That will be 1 1/4 inches. I'm going to put a little lubricant on this now. And the trick with this, as I've learned, is to go slow. Add a little more lubricant. You have to make sure you keep track of your diameters. Okay, and we have reached our 1 1/4 diameter. So let's confirm our diameter here. We have 1 8/32, which is 1 1/4 inches, exactly what we're shooting for. Now we've got to clean this hole up a little bit, get some of the rough edges and loose metal off there. So let me grab a file. So we're just gonna take some of these extra metal pieces off here. And just knock off any super sharp edges. And that should do it. You can see where this hole is in relation to where the handle end of the spit goes through, just slightly to one side. And that still, if I'm doing indirect with rotisserie, will keep the sensor port away from being exposed directly over charcoal. Now it's time to actually install the silicone sensor port. So what I'm gonna do is you're probably gonna need a pair of needle nose pliers or something like that. It can take a little bit of effort. If it's really hard, you can add some liquid dish soap, which makes it easier. But just watch. If you push from one side to get the opposite little wing through, it helps. You just gotta take your time. Take your time and work it through. There we go. That is in, and it's actually aligned just about the way I want it with this hole at the top. I'm just gonna see if I can adjust it slightly, turn it that way. There, our sensor port is in. Let's take a look at it from the outside. So there is the sensor port on the outside. I'll easily be able to feed a probe right through this top one, which will then protrude slightly inside to give me my temperatures. Or I can feed full wires through either there or this slot below. I'm not gonna have to pinch any more wires between the lip of the rotisserie attachment and the lid of the kettle. There you can see how it's gonna look with the lid on. I really am going to appreciate this modification the next time a rotisserie anything, which is in just a couple days, because I'm going to be doing several turkeys on the rotisserie this year for Thanksgiving. Hope you found this video helpful, and if you decide to try it and add this sort of port to your rotisserie or to any of your cookers, I hope you find that helpful too. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. It sure does help. And if you want to see more videos like this, including cooking videos, consider subscribing to my channel. That way you'll get a notification anytime I put up a new video. And if you want to see information on any of the things I used in this video, like that sensor port, I'll put links down in the description so you can check them out for yourself. Thanks again for watching, everybody. Hope you have a great day, and I'll see you again soon.